In this video, I will demonstrate how you can import database information from an Excel file. I will import information from following file. My Excel file contains four sheets. The first one contains the information I will import during this import routine. The rows correspond to my samples. The first row contains the column names. The first column lists the unique IDs of my samples. In Excel, it is possible to save a range of cells. This might be of interest if you only want to import part of the information that is present in a sheet. As an example, I will make a selection only containing the first five rows and three columns. I will call my selection subset 1 and save the changes. Imported information will be stored in the Database Entries panel. This panel is located on the left-hand side in the main window. The key field is a default information field. In this database, I have already added a second field called Genus. I will add more fields when importing the data from the Excel file. When I press the Import button in the main window, the second option under the topic Entry Information Data allows me to import database information from an Excel file. When I click on Import, I need to select my Excel file in the next step. The location of the file is updated. All sheets are displayed in the drop-down list. If named ranges are saved with the Excel file, they are listed here as well. Since I want to import all information from the strain information sheet, I select the sheet from the list. I click on Next. And now I need to create an import template for my data format. All column names found in my sheet are listed under the column source. In this grid, I can choose which fields I would like to import into my database. The first column in the selected sheet contains my entry IDs. To link this information to the key field, I click on the first row in the grid, press the Edit Destination button, and select the key item from the list. The grid information is updated. Further, I would like to write the content of the genus column to an existing database field. I therefore click on the genus field. Next on Edit Destination. I select a field from the list and click OK. Finally, I would like to link my other fields to new information fields in my database. With the Shift key, I can select multiple rows in the grid. I select Edit Destination, select Entry Info field, and press OK. I am prompted to give my fields a name. The column names that appear in the sheet are suggested but can be changed if desired. I confirm the action. By clicking the Preview button, I can check whether the fields have been assigned correctly. If so, I can close this window and click Next. As an entry link field, I will use the key, as this is the unique identifier for my entries. A name for my template is prompt for. Pressing OK saves the template to the database. I select the template and click Next to go to the final step. Pressing the Finish button starts the import. The information is added to the database and the corresponding entries are selected. This ends this video. For other import and analysis routines, I invite you to view our other movies. Thanks for watching.